Good morning to everybody. It's a pleasure to stay online with you in a crazy and hard times, but we try to do our best in order to be connected, in order to be upgraded. Today I'm going to share with you my tips and tricks on body sculpting with body tight with internal RF. And most of you, I know that you are a user, so I try to be precise as possible, and I try to give specific information and not just general information. We have also a session of questions, so if you have any kind of detail or question that you want to ask me, for me it will be a pleasure to answer. I like to have interactional training and webinar. It's for most of you know me, I'm Salvatore Pagana, I'm an Italian plastic surgeon. I live in Spain, and it's more than 10 years that I work on minimal invasive treatment. I have a lot of system, and I like very much RF. It's more than 8 years that I have the body tight platform, and I'm very happy with it. Basically, for two reasons. One of it is that I'm very strong. I'm able to heat the tissue. I'm able to have the tightening of the tissue because we have a selective heating of the septum. In the last training, I entered in the details about this kind of technology. So remember that is a bipolar radio frequency, and we have two poles. We have the energy between the two poles. So everything that is in the middle is going to be heated. And as the septum offer less resistance than fat, we are able to heat selectively the septum more than fat. So this is a system that is very strong for the tissue tightening, even more than the lipolytic effect. But you have also a lipolytic effect. So this is the first reason why I decided to buy this system. The second reason is that we have the control of the temperature. That is very important. So we are able to know exactly in any moment live what is happening inside and outside. That is very important in order to have effective result and reproducible result and safe result, because we are able to know which are the temperature that we want to achieve. One thing we have to have that is important that we have in our mind, especially when you start, you think that as much energy you deliver, as better will be the result, because it's supposed to be more effective. But in fact, there is not this kind of relationship. I show you this kind of slides in order to show you that when we start stimulating the tissue, because we are heating the tissue and expect an answer, a biological answer. So if you see, I have the biological stimulation and the tissue reaction. The biological stimulation is the heating, is the energy. Tissue reaction is the result. So if we start and we use less energy that necessary, we will expect a poor result because we will not see the result. Okay. If we increase the energy, we will see a good result. So we will see the result that we expected. But if we stimulate more than necessary the tissue, because sometimes you think, okay, this is a very bad tissue, I want to stimulate as much as possible and deliver a lot of energy. In that case, we will see a bad result. We will have problem. So my first message is try to understand that if you don't see the answer, it could be that you didn't enough deliver enough energy. but it could be also that it was not the right indication. So like always, in our case, the most important thing is the right indication. We have to select the patient. We need to know that there is a good quality of tissue in order to expect the good retraction. Because if we don't see the retraction of the tissue, it's not caused. Some of parameters is
I'm sorry, guys. It seems that we have a problem with the connection. We will be back in a few minutes.
Mind that we're checking for technical difficulties. We're having temporary tech.
Hello, guys. We have temporary difficulties with the connection of Dr. Salvatore Pagano. He's trying to connect again, reconnect, and we will be back shortly. Stay with us for a few minutes.
You see me? No, this is. You heard me on the.
Now we can hear you again.
Inshallah.
Now we can hear you again. Yeah.
Inshallah. Sorry, guys. I have a bad connection here. This is another corona effect. The corona take place in my laptop. I needed to change it. I don't know what happening, but connection was not good. Let's try to see if we are lucky now. You heard me? Thanks to stay tuned. I think that we were on this slide. You hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you now.
We hear you, Dr. Pagano.
You see the screen?
Yeah, and we see the screen. You can continue from here.
Inshallah.
And we've got some more attendees coming, so welcome and let's start again.
Yes, thank you for staying tuned, and I see that now we have more participants. I do it in order to wait the other one. It was done for this reason. I'm joking. Okay, so I was talking about which are the parameters that we need to keep in mind when we are doing this kind of procedures. So what we need to know is that energy, of course, it's important, but it's not the only one parameters that we need. It's important also the temperature, because depending on the temperature, of course, we will expect a biological effect. And keep in mind that I will show in a slide which are the parameters that I usually use for the temperature internally and externally. But there is also a relationship with the surface. So as big as the surface, we are going to treat, obviously, as much as the energy that we calculate that we are going to deliver. Usually, I use a clinical endpoint that is one end for one end, 10-15 kilojoules in the body, and it depends, of course, on the thickness of the tissue that we are going to treat. So, as thick is it, especially the subcutaneous layer, as much energy we need to deliver in order to have the lipolytic effect. And of course, it depends also on the quality of the tissue, because as better is the quality of the tissue, as better we will expect the retraction. So keep in mind, if we have a poor, thin skin, bad quality, strias, stretch marks, and all this stuff, we need to talk with the patient always before. So keep in mind, talk with the patient before, because after it's too late. They need to know which are the possible results. And I always tell the patient that the result is always the combination of what I do in the operating room and what they, the answer, the tissue answer after the stimulation, in order to have a responsibility of the patient in the result. So if we don't see the result, it could be that I need needed to do better during the operation room, but sometimes it depends also on the patient, the quality, elasticity, the retraction, and if they do exercise, diet, and all this stuff. So try to educate the patient, because this is a biological treatment. I always tell to all my patients, and I'm not cutting the skin. So if the skin retracts, it's up to you under my stimulation. Dilution is important, because we are using the client solution or some lidocaine solution in order to have less pain. So depending on how much volume you infiltrate and the temperature of the client solution, you will need more time in order to achieve and to reach the temperature. So keep in mind the temperature of the dilution, the infiltration, and the temperature of the operating room. And it's important also how you deliver the energy, because if you use a fanning technique, You need to know that close to the access point, as I showed in the other workshop, you can heat too much the tissue. Of course, there is a coefficient of absorption to say that the tissue absorbs the energy in different ways. So in this case, as I told you, collagen receptor absorb energy even faster than fat. So this is what I always have in my mind. In the deep layer, I'm able to use higher temperature because I'm quite safe, because I need more energy for the lipolytic effect and also for the septum heating. So internally, I work between 55, 60, 65 degrees. Internally, this is my internal temperature. Superficially, I put 40, 41, 42 degrees because I'm sure that with this temperature, I'm able to denaturate the collagen of the dermis. Keep in mind that if you have a thin skin with stretch mark, try to be more generous. So I move to 42, and if it's a good quality of skin, thick, male, or young patient, it's enough even 30, 56 or 38 degrees. Try to adjust the temperature in order to the quality of the tissue. And this is what I told you, that usually I deliver 10, 15 kilojoules for thermalzol. Thermalzol is an end. And if it's a thick layer, I put a little bit more, 15. It's okay. But I usually use a clinical endpoint. So in the deep layer, I heat the tissue until I feel that there is resistance. And superficially, I heat the skin until I feel that I've reached the temperature. I see that I've reached the temperature 40, 41, 42 degrees. So keep in mind, in the deep layer, when you feel the lipolytic effect, and superficially when you reach the temperature that you have already set it. That is very, very easy, because once you know what you are doing and you have the possibility to check what is happening, is quite easy. So externally, 40, 41, 42, depending on the quality of the skin. And this is the way in order to don't have a burn externally. And internally, I usually start with 55, and if necessary, I move to 60, to 65. So the internal one for me is like the power, how fast I want to go. So I start with 55. And if I heat homogeneously, the temperature is okay. If I'm too slow, I raise to 55, to 65, to 60, 65, even 70. And if I'm too fast, I slow down the internal temperature, because I want to homogeneously cook the tissue in order to have a homogeneous effect. So remember, slow food, no fast food, slow food. I'm Italian and I like too much the slow food. This is something that I have always in my mind. When a patient come to my practice, so how easy is for me the treatment, depending on the area. So if we have a fibrotic area with a good thick dermis, like flanks, like trunk, it's quite easy to have a good result. Okay, even the knee, if it's a good dermis knee, not the one with wrinkles. You see that even the neck and face for me are easy. The base is the easiest one, and the top is the most difficult one. So for me, the most difficult one, of course, are cellulite. Why is the cellulite one of the most difficult? Because the cellulite is a multi-pathological, multifactorial pathology. So it depends on the veins, the return of the laxity, atrophy, microcirculation. So there are many factors that influence the result. So my suggestion is, when you treat cellulite, don't promise too much. Take caution, because you can achieve result, but it's not easy. Also, abdomen is very tricky, because there are a lot of septum inside. So take care, because it's very easy to have this homogeneity. This guy's. I'm going to organize another webinar where I'm going to talk only about complication. So stay tuned, because we are going to organize also this kind of webinar. Now, what I'm going to focus for area. So I will not speak in general. I will speak which are my tips and tricks and which are my parameters for the most interesting area. So if we have a fibrotic area like flanks, like trunk, this is an easy area for me. Even without body tight, without thermal stimulation, we will achieve a result. So in this case, you don't need to put too much energy. I suggest you 10 kilojoules for thermal zone is enough. The parameters that I set is externally 40 degrees, and even 38 degrees is enough. Externally, yes. Internally, you can use 55, 60 degrees. Try to take care and to be homogeneous, and keep in mind that the trunk and the flanks are a very curved area, and you work with a straight cannula. If you go straight until the end of the cannula, you can have some micro burns in that area. So keep in mind to move fast the cannula and don't go until the end. So stay always in the middle, not too close to the access point and not too far until the end of the cannula. You can aspirate and eat at the same time, especially if you have a thick layer. I usually do the deep layer, superficial layer, and then aspirate at the end. But if you want, especially with the old cannula, you can heat and aspirate at the same time. But keep in mind that these are two different things. One is heating and the other is aspiration. If you are doing it at the same time, sometimes you can eat too much, or sometimes you can eat less than necessary, or you can aspirate too much. So I'm a man, I'm not a woman, I'm not able to do two or three things at the same time. So I try to do the heating and then the aspiration. Why I start with eating? Because I like to respect the anatomy of the area in order to let the energy and the electricity flow so to the septum with their integrity. So try to respect them. Hola. Sì. Mira, te do un numero di telefono, ok? Appuntate questo numero di telefono. Sto in chirofano. Appuntate questo numero di telefono. Sei dos. 100. Sorry, eh? It drives me crazy and they were talking all the time and I'm connected with the sound. Do you hear me?
Yes, we hear you now in English.
Yeah, sorry for the live, eh? Crazy, yeah. Crazy Italian Spanish time. Okay. So this is an area that doctors ask me a lot, because you can see we are able to achieve very, very interesting result in the arms without surgery. This is very interesting because the other option, that is dermal lipectomy, is a very ugly option in my opinion, because the scar is very long, it's from the axilla to the elbow, and it is not a good quality of scar, because the arm has a lot of mobility. So if we are able to give the patient this option without no scar, for me is a very, very, very important advantage, and I'm very happy with this result. Now a patient that come for this problem, eight of them I do the body type, just to I do the short scar in only in the axilla, not the only one. So in this case, especially when you have an areolar fat like in the inner thigh, even the arms, you need to be a little bit more aggressive with the energy. So I deliver 15 kilojoules, even 20 kilojoules. Do you hear me? You hear me?
We hear you, Dr. Pagano. We hear you. We read you all the time.
Okay, thank you very much. I need some feedback because I feel alone in the universe.
And we will never leave you alone.
Liverpool support, unlike Adrian. Okay, so in this case, in the arm, it's very important. Try to be generous. So I put externally 42 degrees. Internally, I don't use higher energy because in the arm you need it to be very, very homogeneous. So I suggest you to use 55 like internal temperature. If you are using the whole the handpiece with just one sensor, use 55. I encourage you to use the older handpiece and when you are using the older handpiece to use the power like the internal temperature. So I use the same parameter to be easier, especially when you start. In this case, I go deep and I deliver 2/3 of the 15 kilojoules, so about 10 kilojoules in the deep layer. I want to hit that septum. I'm very close to the fascia muscle, so try to hit as much as possible. Then I move superficial and I reach the 42 degrees. And then I do externally the Morpheus, because I want to be sure that the skin will retract as much as possible. One important concept in this area is that you need to leave at least 1.5 centimeters of fat. So I hit the deep layer, I hit the superficial layer, and then I aspirate, but I aspirate leaving 1.5 centimeters. Some doctors ask me, is necessary to aspirate? I can tell you that it's better for two reasons. First of all, because you aspirate and you remove lidocaine and adrenaline. So you avoid the pharmacological effect. Second of all, you aspirate the fatty acid that activate arachidonic chain. So you have inflammation. If you don't aspirate that fat, macrophages need to go there. So you need you will expect more inflammation. If I aspirate, I will see a fast result. And third of all, in this case, there is the gravity that acts on the area. So the skin needs to retract, and we need not an heavy flap. As thin as possible, the skin will retract. But keep in mind to leave a 1.5 centimeter, because I had two patients that I aspirate too much, and the problem was not the sagittal skin. The problem was that the retraction was so important that the skin was completely fixed to the muscle, and it was not so aesthetic because you see the triceps, and is the patient concerned about it. And I needed to put lipofilling to correct it. So keep in mind to leave at least 1.5 centimeters. Access point, this is another question that doctors make me very, very well. Basically, when the patient lay down, I try to see where I need to go with the cannula in order to have the better access point. So in any area, I try to lay down the patient, then I decide where to make the incision. Of course, you need to know the anatomy and take care about the ulnar nerve, but usually I do it in the axilla, in the epicondylus. Let's go ahead. This is our result. Same patient, you can see a good retraction, no scar. If we want to see very, 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 very accurate, she has some in the periaxillary area, she has some laxitude there. You can correct it with a short scar axilla, but I can tell you the patient is very happy and she didn't want nothing else. So sometimes we are even more we pretend more than our patient. This is another area that patient ask me a lot, and doctor are very interested in it. Look, this is a patient with a very big and important change. Of course, it's not easy to achieve this kind of result. You see, it's the same patient. You see the result and the same proportion. I try to be as much accurate as possible, you know, to say how much fat I was able to remove in this case. This is a patient where I do it in two sessions, and I remove almost 3 liters in any session. So I do the first session under the knee and then above the knee. And in this case, take care about the quality of the tissue. So in this case, we have bad circulation, we have cellulite, we have a lot of problems. So use high energy because we want to tight too much as possible. But especially if you treat all the leg, keep in mind that you are eating also the lymphatic circuit. So this patient had already problem with the lymphatic drainage. And if you stimulate it, they will have more problem in this field. So I suggest you that, especially if you have this kind of legs, to do it in two sessions and tell the patient before the treatment that they can feel swelling during 1 month, even 2 months in the leg, but also on the feet, and that they needed to use comfortable shoes. Most of time it does not happen, especially if you do into session, but it's better to tell the patient. I try to use internally 55-60 degrees and externally 42 degrees. I go deep, I go superficially. I deliver 15 kilojoules for thermal zone. Try to hit the access point as much as possible. So I put in the inguinal area, in the knee, and in the popliteal area. When you have a cellulite associated, I like to use a Toledo cannula, a big cannula, micro one, in order to don't have a big dissection, and it helps you to improve the quality of the tissue. So I'm very superficial, I cut the septum, I hit it, and I do morpheo superficially. If you can use also cellulite, but in order to have the best option, and don't use too many cannulas. If I open a body tight, I use body tight for everything. I don't need to open another cannula. Another important key point is that I do not use energy. I do not use body tight under the knees. Why? Because you have a dermal plexus and you can damage it even with a normal conventional cannula. So take care of it because you can have some pigmentation there, and this is not hyperpigmentation. This is a damage of the plexus, dermal plexus, vascular dermal plexus, and it needs a lot of time in order to recover. So take care and be very gentle, especially under the knee. You can treat it and you can see the result, but take care of it. You see? And you see on the back, you see in the popliteal area, I don't know if you see my arrow. You see this? This is not hyperpigmentation. This is damage of the plexus vascular nervous, because I try to be as gentle as possible, but the vascularization of the area was very, very, very bad. It's going to recover, but it needs 1 year and 2 years. And I always tell the patient that it could happen. Patient don't care about it. She's crazy, she's happy, because she say that now she can, for the first time, she can use the skirt. And but I saw it. And I tell it that she is going to improve, but she needs time, and you need to give the patient angiohelp. Gluteal area. This is a very interesting area. Keep in mind that the gluteal area, and that there are many, many books that are interesting. Most of you, I'm sure that you know Tino Mendieta. And he has a book that I suggest you to read it, because it helps you to understand this area very, very, very well. In our job, the most important things is the proportion. We are like sculptors. We need to know which are the proportion of the area in order to know what to remove and what to leave. So this is very important, the gluteal area, because we need to understand the frame. And with the frame, I suggest you, if you are going to treat the gluteal area, always treat the flanks, because the flanks is a very good area, fibrotic area. It retracts very well, and it helps you to shape the waist the waist, but also the gluteal area. So you have a more projection because you remove the volume in the upper part. If you are going to treat the gluteal area, take care that you have a lipolytic effect. So if you have a lipolytic effect, you can flatten the gluteus area. So I recommend you to go very, very superficially if you want the tightening effect, and to go deep just in the flank area, but don't be deep in the gluteal area and in the banana fold, because the banana fold, this area, is the support, is the capital of the gluteal area. If you remove too much fat in this area, the gluteal area will collapse, will drop down. So take care about it. So what I do, I treat the flanks, I treat the tochanteric area, but I respect, I'm very superficial on the banana area and then the gluteal area. And in the gluteal area, if you have cellulite, I treat it with microtoledo cannula with cellulite if needed. And in order to avoid the flattening, sometimes I inject even some fat. So the fat that I removed from the flanks and from the trochanteric area, I make a microfat graft and I inject in the gluteal area, especially in the superior part. Okay. And this is another interesting area. This is the abdomen. So abdomen, take in mind that is a tricky area. Why? Because there is a lot of septum. There is a big network. So it's not easy. It's not easy to have. It's easy to have a good result, but if you not eat homogeneously the tissue, you can have a lot of irregularities. So keep in mind and try to use low energy. 55 is enough, because if you want to go fast, sometimes you can and you don't eat homogeneously the tissue, and you can have irregularities. So in this case, I make incision in the inguinal area and the umbilicus, even in the women inframammary fold, or if I want to sculpt the superior part of the abdomen. 10 kilojoules for thermal zone is enough. Usually I deliver 2/3 in the deep layer and 1/3 in the superficial layer. And you see this patient, this is a patient that had a radian abdominoplasty. And come to me after the abdominoplasty, you see the scar, you see the umbilicus. He had the flap removal, but he didn't have contour. And he came to me in order to have the contour, because I treated the one of his friend. And you see, without touching the scar is the same. And without do surgical procedures, I just do body tight and I remove a lot of fat. I remove almost 6 liters in this patient. I was able to have this kind of sculpting. Of course, the patient go to gym and helps in order to have this kind of definition. So in this case, what I do the deep layer with the body tight, I do the superficial until I feel that I've liquefied the fat. Then I move superficial until I reach 40-41 degrees. Then I use the micro air in order to shape the abdomen, and I remove, of course, more volume in the insertion of the muscle with the Alfred Hoyos technique. And after this, I just heat superficially the area of the insertion in order to have an extra retraction. That's the way to do the IDEF abdomen, the six pack, and this kind of high definition that are a trend topic. This is another area that is very interesting, and I suggest you don't start with the breast, because it's not easy area, and there is a glands, so there are some issue on it. But I can tell you that if there is a good quality of skin, and you heat all the area, especially with the periareal access point, you will see a good result. In this case, you need to go very superficial. You can use face tight, you can use even a smaller body type. Heat the thermal skin until 42 degrees, just the superficial layer, and combine with the fractura. It's interesting also to combine the tightening of the skin with the filling, because this kind of patient usually have some lack of volume. So if we are using a lipofilling, it will be interesting to fulfill it. And the last area that I wanted to share with you my parameters and my trip is the dermal area. So we are talking about acne, but the dermis of the face, but also the dermis of axilla in hyperhidrosis. If we tighten this kind of dermis, we expect a shrinking. And if we heat the glands that are inside, that could be the sebaceous gland in the acne, or they could be the hidrosis glands in hyperhidrosis, we will expect dermal contraction, and we will expect glands in activation. That's the reason why it works very well in the acne. So I suggest you and encourage you to use in the acne. You can use Morpheus alone, or you can use the Morpheus, the AccuTite, or the FaceTite combined with Morpheus, and also in the hyperhidrosis. In this case, you need to go very, very superficial. You need to treat just the dermis. You need to be aggressive. So reach 42 degrees, deliver 5-10 kilojoules is enough, because we are talking, we are stimulating just the superficial layer, and combine it with the Morpheus. And it's good to combine and to repeat Morpheus every 1.5 months, and combine with ancillary procedures, especially if we are talking about the acne. You can combine with the PRP, we can combine with salicylic acid peeling. Sorry, I need some water. Okay, so just to finish, tell you that these are my tips and tricks, and I show you my experience, 11 years of experience in this country. But of course, you need your learning curve, and once you do patient, you realize and you understand things that are important for you, and use your personal parameters. So I'm telling you what are my parameters and what are my access points. But the most important thing here is to know how it works, and to know the biological effect and how to reach it. Then parameters and access point, these are a little bit secondary. So I encourage you to start with your learning curves. And of course, best results are not the first result. And whenever you want, you are more than welcome here in Seville. Or I can come to visit you if your city is nice. So we can start now with some question on the audience. I'm connected with the chat. You can write me, or you can write with Judy or Paloma.
Thank you, doctor. I see you have a question there from Kate.
Let me see, where is it? Okay, then to everybody to be connected, to stay tuned until the end. I don't see any answer. Could you please write me a question if you have any? You hear me?
Yes, we hear you. I don't see okay, I see a question from Mr. Alla. What is the best way for cellulite if the problem is only cellulite?
Yes, cellulite, I talk about it during the training. So cellulite is a multifactorial pathology and is a superficial pathology. So I suggest you, infiltrate the area. If it's a small area, you can do even under local anesthesia. Go superficial and heat the dermis and the superficial subcutaneous layer. Use internally 55, even 60 degrees, externally 42 degrees, because you need to heat the skin a lot in order to have the tightening of this of that skin. If you want, you can use a cellulite. If you are going to treat just cellulite, I suggest you to use a cellulite, because a cellulite is a sharp tip that helps you to cut the septum. If not, you can use also a botulido cannula, so a small cannula with the P that have the same effect. And even sometimes I combine cellulite with botulido cannula, because I want to be totally sure that I'm cutting the septum. I reach 42 degrees everywhere, and externally I treat with Morpheus 3 millimeter and 2 millimeter 45 or 50 kilojoules if the phototype is a white phototype. If not, use less energy. And if it's a gluteal area, I put even some like filling in order to help the convexity and the projection of the area.
We have another question, Dr. Pagano, regarding the large Thai lady. Was this procedure undertaken with general anesthesia?
The large?
Thai, the case with the Thai, the large Thai.
Yes, it was with the sedation. I have a rule in my mind that if it's less than 1 liter that I'm going to suck, I go under local anesthesia. If it's more than 1 liter, I prefer to do under sedation, because it's much more comfortable. And if you are going to inject big volume, sometimes a patient can feel some pain in some area and is discomfortable, and I need to be concentrated on the treatment. So I prefer to do under sedation, and is the hospital treatment. So they do the treatment and go home after 2-3 hours.
Thank you. We have another question regarding thermal zone. What do you mean by thermal zone?
Yes,
Dr. Muhammad.
I give it thermal zone for me is 1 inch. Okay, is 10 or 15 centimeters. We call it especially one. Doctors that come here, we are talking about always about it. So, in order to be as empiric as possible, to calculate how much energy we needed to deliver in the body, 1 inch is 10-15 kilojoules. Okay, and this is a thermal zone, 1 inch. So it's more or less 10-15 kilojoules. In the face is half of it. So, for example, for a neck, is between 6-10 kilojoules. And for any area in the face is 1-3 kilojoules for additional area. I mean inferior third of the face, jawlines, periorbital area, and all this stuff. But thermal zone is 1 inch.
Thank you. We have a question regarding breast lifting. Are you do all zone or only the upper zone of the breast?
This is interesting. There is not a protocol, but I can tell you that if you want just to push to lift the areola, it's enough to stimulate the area between the jugular area and the nipple. Okay, so just the superior pole of the area. But try to do vertical vectors, because I told you that every time we enter with the cannula, we make like a threads, and the tissue will shrink in that direction. So I try to use as longest and as vertical as possible my vectors with the body tight. But if you have a square breast, for example, those cases that are candidate for a periareolar mastopexy, but you don't want to do a periareolar mastopexy, you want to do just a breast augmentation with infra inframammary access point, I do it all the breast. So I do access point in the periareolar zone and in the inframammary fold, and I eat superficially all the breast.
Thank you. We have everybody are saying it was a great webinar, and we have a lot of questions. I will give you a few more regarding the legs. The case of the legs from Dr. Romana is asking if you applied body tight below the knees, or you applied there only liposuction, or both. And also, could you repeat the techniques that you applied for the six pack in the abdomen for men?
Yes. So first question, in the legs below the knee, I don't use the body tight. I don't use any kind of eating below the knee. Why? Because the vascularization is not good in this kind of this patient. This patient have a lipoedema, is a lymphedema, and is very dangerous to hit the vascular network, this area, because they will not drain well, and you can damage the plexus, the dermal vascular plexus. So I suggest you don't use body tight under the knee. Why? You don't need it, because the skin of the popliteal area retracts very, very well. Even you see, I remove more than 2 liters just below the knee, and the skin retract very well. No sagging skin there. I use the body tuck above the knee, so between the inguinal area and the knee. I'm very generous with the heating, because that skin is a poor skin, and you need to eat it in order to have the best retraction. And the other question was the six pack. So six pack. First of all, right indication. Don't do six pack to a visceral patient with a lot of visceral fat, because if you do it, you will have a ninja turtle effect. So it will not a great result. If you have the right patient, somebody that take care of himself, that go to the gym, that is a very good base. In this case, I do it the IDEF abdomen. And what I do, I infiltrate the area, then I go deep. I use parameter 55 internally and 40 externally, and I heat internally until I feel that it's liquefied, usually 10 kilojoules for area. Then I move superficially and I heat until 40 degrees, 38, 40 degrees, because usually these patients have very good quality of skin and they are male patient. Then I use microair, that is pulse system, but you can use also normal conventional liposuction, and I aspirate the deep volume everywhere, and I aspirate superficial volume only on the insertion of the muscle. So I'm very aggressive on the insertion of the muscle in order to scalp and to make the edge of the area. And after that, I give an extra heating just on the area of the insertion in order to have the best retraction there. So very, very superficial retrograde stimulation in order to have the tightening of the insertion.
Thank you. We have an interesting question. Do you prefer to do liposuction than body tight, or vice versa?
If I prefer to do body tight and then lipo, or vice, is this the question?
Yes.
Okay. I told you, everybody has his own protocol. There are doctors. I do deep layer with body tight, superficial layer with body tight, and then I aspirate. Unless I have a very thick layer and I have the old tank cannula, and I aspirate and eat at the same time. I use this protocol because I like to heat the tissue when there is an intact anatomy of the septum, and there is an intact integrity of all the structures. So I'm able, I know exactly that I'm hitting all the septum and the electricity go through that septum and I didn't touch it. But there are doctors that aspirate and then do body type, and they have also good results. So up to you. What I suggest you, if you want to aspirate before, of course, you have less volume, you have less liquid, so you will expect to eat faster. But keep in mind that you need to go deep with the cannula. So don't go just superficially, because the collagen is not only in the dermis, but it's also in the deep layer. So if you are able to eat the deep layer, the deep network, and superficially, you will expect the best retraction. So go deep and go superficial. And there are doctors that combine technology that they have. If you have a vaser, for example, what you can do is go the deep layer with the vaser, because vaser work well for the lipolytic effect, and then go with the, then aspirate, and then go with the body tight in order to eat the septum and the dermis. So better to understand how it works more than use closed protocol and guideline.
And when can we expect the final results, asking by Dr. Kirdo?
We will expect the best result after 6-8 months. So this is what I tell to all my patients. There are areas that have a faster retraction, for example, the flanks, trunks, for example, the arms, for example, the neck, they retract even after weeks. But usually the best result and the final result is after 6 months. So you need to talk with the patient. You need to say that the volume is something that you will see immediately, less volume because you remove it, but the skin need time. And I always give the patient the example of the pregnancy. After the pregnancy, the skin needs some time in order to retract. And that's what we are doing. We are not cutting, we are stimulating, and then we have to wait for the retraction. And we don't know exactly how much is going to retract. So this is what I tell the patient. And I always give another example to the patient, that is the scar. I say, if I take a knife and I make the same incision on my hand, on your hand, and on the other friend hand, with the same knife and the same hand and the same operator, I will have a keloid, she will have a good scar, and the other one could have a hypertrophic scar. Which is the matter? It depends on the quality of the skin. And the patient understand this example in order to let them understand that if we don't see 100% retraction, it's not because the treatment or the surgeon was not good, but because of the skin. So it's a way in order to put the patient in the result. And the patient understand it, and I tell them, we will expect more than 50%. But then it's up to you, and it's up to what you do, because we have a window of 6-8 months, and during these six months, you need to have collagen every day, you need to use compressing garments, you need to use socks, you need to have a diet, you need to go to the gym, because if you don't change your attitude, you will not expect the best and excellent results.
Okay, I think that is it. Thank you, Dr. Pagano. Thank you, everybody, for joining us.
Thank you to everybody. My pleasure.
Stay home.
Thank you. Exactly. Stay home. And
stay home, and we will send you all the links for the next webinar.
Thank you very much. Ciao.
Ciao, ciao. Bye.